A whole new season of the Toyo Tyres Motorsport UK British Rallycross Championship kicks off here at Silverstone this weekend, and once again, the defending champion is missing from the grid, and that leaves the way clear for another new name to be the champion come the end of 2019. Julian Godfrey, five times a champion already, starts as the favourite. But this weekend at Silverstone, a former Irish champion, Derek Tohill, is on the grid, and if he commits to a full season, he could be a major thorn in Godfrey's side. It's a circuit that lends itself to close racing and great action, and here's a taste of what's in store.
Julian Godfrey, your ninth commitment to the British Rallycross Championship in Supercar. You've won the championship five times, back with a Mirage here at Silverstone. What are your expectations for this season and today?
Want to try and get another title. Been the Mirage for this weekend, but maybe back into the Fiesta for Lydon, but see what we can come up with.
Derek Tohill, welcome back to the British Rallycross Championship. It's been a while. What are your expectations for your return?
Enjoy the weekend, enjoy the championship. Looks like an interesting championship, seems to be well organised, and looking forward to a track that I've only tried on dirt rally during the week, so just done a couple laps of practice and it seems pretty similar to the game, so game on.
Ollie, you were quite confident after practice this morning that things were going okay, but seemingly you found out otherwise.
Yeah, we were very happy after practice, we felt really good. It was a reasonably quick practice and I had so much more to give, and we had a little rattle come into the engine and we discovered the crank was broken. So this paid an end to our day. We didn't bring our second engine, we have a new development engine, so we'll probably have to get that one sorted maybe and be back out in Lydon Hill hopefully.
We are ready to go racing here at Silverstone. Lights go out and the supercars blast away. Derek Tohill takes on in this race Liam Manning and Steve Hill. And he's already in the lead as they get to turn one through that tight right-hander, still on the tarmac. And Derek Tohill racing here for the first time. Didn't come to any of the events last year, either the World Championship event nor the two British rounds. So it's a step into the unknown. And he's got to learn and go quickly and keep the opposition at bay as he comes over the jump now. Out of turn five, this is Steve Hill's view and he's hard at work. This reworked Mitsubishi going better than ever, looked better as well. But Derek Tohill is outpacing him for the moment as they come down towards that hairpin at turn seven. Up towards now the choice between the normal lap and the Joker lap. On board with Hill as he threads his way through that normal route. And behind look is the Subaru in the hands of Liam Manning as they come now up towards the end of lap number one. Derek Tohill though is getting away very definitely. Manning Jr., Liam Manning next in the queue as they turn their way through turn one. Up now towards that chicane. Right and left at two and three, you go from tarmac to loose, and then just as you've got the car straightened up, nail the throttle and you're over that jump, and you can see how much dust there is, and that's Manning cannoning into the tyre stack. Lost visibility. A year ago we were complaining about the Arctic conditions and the snow and the sleet. Today it's the sun and the dust. Derek Tohill turns the car now through turn five. Steve Hill under braking a little bit nearer, but then he runs out wide. Now, how much damage did Liam Manning pick up? Steve Hill goes for the Joker lap. It's tighter, it's slower, and he's all sideways on that strip of tarmac now. Back onto the loose, then to the tarmac again, onto the normal route, onto the last lap. Derek Tohill leaving the Joker to the end, seemingly on target for a race win. Now, it's not a huge supercar entry this weekend, but it's enough to split them into two groups, at least for Q1. Therefore, as Tohill lands heavily, it's not only his race win, but his race time that we need to compare with whatever happens in the next race. There is Steve Hill, not quite as airborne as he comes then over the jump. Out of turn five now, Steve Hill sideways, but Derek Tohill looks as though he's heading for a race win. Tohill goes to the Joker lap, onto the handbrake, flicks the back round. That's Steve Hill powering his way up towards the line, but Derek Tohill will have done enough as he comes up towards the line. Derek Tohill wins his first ever race around the Silverstone Rallycross track from Steve Hill in second place. But is it going to be enough to get the best time? Race two about to get underway here at Silverstone. Ollie Bennett missing from pole position. So Julian Godfrey in the Mitsubishi Mirage launches away to take on Pat Doran, Mike Manning and Steve Mundy. Godfrey, I would expect, is going to be the man to beat in this race. And what he's now got to do is try to beat a time of 3 minutes 6.8 to go quickest in Q1. Julian Godfrey, five times a British Rallycross champion, leads the way as they come onto the loose for the first time. The dust hanging in the air, Marshall's choking as the dust affects them, but Godfrey's already built up an advantage. Mike Manning then hard onto the heels of Pat Doran as they turn their way out of the right-hander at turn five. Doran it is then who has the advantage, at least in this battle, to be second. And Pat Doran himself, of course, multiple British champion, came to Silverstone at the back end of last year for the final round, enjoyed it, and he's back hopefully for a full season. Mike Manning jokers and now gets back on track, but you see how much time that joker lap loses you. Do you do it first and get it out of the way? Do you try and push and build a gap and then do the joker at the very end? Silverstone is one of the rare circuits where the joker is at the end of a lap, not at the start. Pat Doran goes through the chicane at turns two and three and he's on the power again. This is Julian Godfrey, hard at work. Out of turn five, strip of tarmac, back to the loose. And the stubby Mitsubishi, demolished at Croft last year with that spectacular accident, looks as though it's going to be the car to beat this season. Derek Tohill, who we saw out in race one, undecided whether it's just a one-off or he will do the whole season. Hopefully he's in for the full year. Pat Doran goes for the joker. Godfrey building the lead, nose drops as he stands on the brakes. Steve Mundy hard at work lower down the order as well. Pat Doran back towards the normal route, but he loses out against Mike Manning. So Mike Manning goes ahead of him. Can he stay there? That's the next question. Through they turn, nose to tail these two. Mike Manning it is, just ahead of Pat Doran, but the Citroën will go through and Manning's got a problem. Mike Manning onto the grass and seemingly into retirement. The new Fiesta for Mike Manning that's going to be doing a European Championship assault this year parks itself trackside. Julian Godfrey has gone for the joker lap. As you look at Pat Doran, there is Godfrey. He threads his way through the tight joker lap sequence and now accelerates up towards the line. The dust behind him, the checkered flag is ahead of him, and Julian Godfrey is on target at the end of this next lap for a race win. The clock ticks on down. 3 minutes 6.8, remember, is the time to beat. Can he do it? Yellow flag waves to say that Mike Manning's car is parked trackside. Now, Steve Mundy with his Fiesta is a long way back in comparison. He's going to get third in the race, but the time, I fear, is not going to be all that sparkling. Steve, who's a former champion in Rallycross Championships of years past, heads for the Yump. As to the checkered flag comes Julian Godfrey. Can he go quicker than Derek Tohill? Yes, he can! A 3 minutes 4.8 as against 3 minutes 6.8. Godfrey defeats Tohill. Steve Hill goes third quickest from Pat Doran, and then Steve Mundy, fifth fastest.
Steve Hill, more revisions to your Mitsubishi over the winter, another exciting prospect and a good run in Q1 this morning.
Yes, first time we've really driven it in anger, very pleased with where it's going. It's pushing on a little bit on the anti-lag, which I'm not used to, which means I can go a bit deep into the corners, but once I get the hang of that, it'll be fine.
Q2 about to get underway. Julian Godfrey is the man on pole position. Derek Tohill alongside him. Steve Hill on the outside of the front row. And Derek Tohill tries to brave it out alongside Godfrey on the way up towards turn one, but he can't do it. Godfrey it is then that has the advantage. Derek Tohill to the inside line, all locked up. You can see the determination. He knows he's got to get ahead of that Mitsubishi. Steve Hill runs third. Pat Doran is fourth. And they head up towards the Yump then now. But it's a very frustrated Derek Tohill who's missed out on that hole shot. Julian Godfrey has the advantage. Out of turn five then towards the loose once again. Hill goes wide and Pat Doran goes even wider in fourth place. Down they come now towards that tight right at turn seven, which is the undoing of many. Pat Doran flicks through that right-hander, keeping Steve Mundy at bay. Mundy goes for the joker lap, so it's Godfrey and Tohill the top two on the normal route as they come over the line at the end of one lap of four. Hard on the brakes, you're on the tarmac, you turn into the right at turn one, and straight away, squirt of acceleration, and then stand on the anchors for turn two and flick left onto the loose towards the Yump out of turn three. Godfrey goes wide. Can Derek Tohill take advantage of that? Maybe draws about half a length nearer, closes up over the Yump, and you land and you have to brake and change down and get the car stable and turn right. Just the one visit of the Toyo Tyres Motorsport UK British Rallycross Championship to Silverstone this year. It also plays host to the World Championship in late May. And Julian Godfrey has the race lead then. He was quickest in Q1 and it looks as though he'll be quickest in Q2. Derek Tohill eating his dust. Over the line they come once more, but Godfrey it is, looking strong so far. Derek Tohill hard at work as the car pendulums its way now up towards the chicane. Tohill, three times an Irish champion, Division 2 champion in the European Rallycross Championship, touring car champion in the European Rallycross Championship. He'd love to become British champion this year as well, no doubt. But right now, Julian Godfrey has got the upper hand. Down towards turn 7. Godfrey turns into that right. He's got greater track knowledge. He was the winner, notionally, here in round 1 last year. As in, he was the highest placed point scorer behind the visiting World Championship drivers. Tohill goes for the joker. And that's Steve Mundy looking to try to pick up places, if at all possible. Steve Mundy accelerating his way out of turn 7. Last lap, Derek Tohill goes through. Steve Hill is the man behind him. Now, can Julian Godfrey be defeated? At the moment, it's looking rather like no, because so strong is that Mitsubishi Mirage. He's getting away. Tohill is next. Now, there is Pat Duran under attack from Steve Mundy. Citroën versus Ford as they dive towards the loose once again. Julian Godfrey on target for the race win, and again to go fastest in a supercar qualifying round. He's got the joker to do. Heads up towards that tight sequence of corners. And Derek Tohill struggling a little bit, maybe out of turn 7. So Godfrey will get back onto the normal line ahead. And Julian Godfrey is on target to win in Q2 here at Silverstone. Derek Tohill chases him across the line to be second. And it's going to be this man, Steve Hill, through for third place. But Julian Godfrey is very much the man to beat today. Julian Godfrey quickest in Q2, Derek Tohill second ahead of Steve Hill, Pat Duran, Steve Mundy fifth, and it's Liam Manning sixth fastest.
Julian Godfrey, once again continuing your incredible work rate of working at events and competing, and you've been fastest twice this morning in supercar. You must be pretty happy with that.
Yeah, very happy with that. It's gone very well in the supercar class. Got a good start again off the line, and kept Derek behind, and had a body into the second queue. I got a bit of a gap between him, so no, going very well.
And just for those that don't know, you're an engineer and an engine builder as well, and you're currently sitting in someone else's car with a pair of laptops. How is it to concentrate for you in these events to do two different roles?
It's no problem for me at all. I can just sort of do my job and then jump in the car and off we go, so no problem at all.
You've been second quickest to Julian twice in the first two qualifiers, second on the grid again for Q3. How's it going?
Yeah, need to get out of that dust, and yeah, dust is quite heavy out there, so if we can get some clear track, but it is incredibly slippy for a dry day. Need to find a little bit of grip, having too much fun with the car sliding around, which isn't the best of ideas, especially when you're trying to beat Julian.
Pat Duran, a four-time British Rallycross champion, you made a couple of appearances last year, notably in the final round at Silverstone in this Citroën C4, and you're back for more this time out. How's it been going?
Terrible. But we think it's going to get better. Well, it's because I'm driving so slowly, the car's being reliable for me. But we're hoping to up the pace this afternoon. I'm just going to be the old dog that's going to catch everyone out behind as they all break down.
Always enjoy driving this car, though. The longitudinal engine setup seems to suit your driving style quite well.
Yeah, because I'm a bit sideways, so this reduces that. I like the long chassis, and it's old school, and I enjoy driving it. Maybe not the fastest car here, but she's a good old girl.
Q3 is about to blast away. This is crucial for Derek Tohill. He's got to make the best start. He's got to get ahead of Godfrey. Bit of creeping. He goes. The lights go green, but he's not as quick out of the blocks as Godfrey. I think he just stopped creeping at exactly the wrong moment, because Julian Godfrey has again got the drop on everybody going into Q1. Steve Hill gets forced out wide, and so Pat Duran goes ahead of him into third place. It is Godfrey versus Tohill, nose to tail. Duran third, Hill is fourth. Fifth is Steve Mundy as they come onto the loose and up towards the jump for the first time. Derek Tohill frustrated, no doubt, because again he's been battered away from the line by Godfrey, but he's right on his tail as they go into turn 5. Steve Hill gets sideways in the Mitsubishi, and it's going really well. Pleasing to see how well the Mitsubishi is going this year as Duran gets all sideways on the approach to turn 7. Track has been watered again in between qualifying rounds just to keep the dust down a little bit. We're in mid-March and we're talking about dust. Steve Mundy goes for the joker and slithers off wide. Maybe it is watered so well that now the grip level has changed. He slithers out wide there. Here are the leaders, Julian Godfrey versus Derek Tohill. Both very accomplished drivers. So too is that man, Pat Duran, in third place. Now, what can Steve Hill do to get ahead of him? He was wide at turn 1 at the start, remember? That's what really cost him the advantage. Duran over the jump. He's not perhaps quite as gung-ho as others, but the last thing you need is a heavy landing and a car failure. Everybody wanting to make sure they get through to the final here. The Inter-Nissan Mannings contest goes on in the background. Mike ahead of Liam, but there's Steve Hill powering his way towards the end of the lap. Mike Mannings heading for the Joker lap, and Derek Tohill peering through the dust that's kicked up at certain parts, sees where Godfrey is. He brakes much, much later for turn one, but the danger is the car then washes out wide and he loses some of that ground he's made up. Across the loose once again, back onto the power here. In the dust you see Steve Mundy joking early on, accelerating his way now up towards turn one. Steve Mundy, 1999, he was a rallycross champion, vastly experienced driver, but the car just not as quick as some of those around. Derek Tohill right on the back of Julian Godfrey once again, and Steve Hill is giving a very tough time to Pat Durham. Godfrey and Tohill both go for the Joker lap this time. There is Derek Tohill slithering off the road, and Godfrey's done exactly the same. They've both gone wide and onto the grass. I think Derek Tohill probably gauged his pace against Julian Godfrey. Steve Hill goes ahead of them, but both of the two race leaders slide off the road on the Joker lap, and had Derek Tohill done it on a different lap and therefore not had the same sort of pace as Godfrey, he may well have come out in the race lead. As it is, it's still the same order. It's strange that they would both have jokered at the same time, but that's what happened. Both slithered off the road and Julian Godfrey regroups ahead. Over the jump they come. Derek Tohill, I reckon, is the more committed over that. He seems to land sideways and closer to the back of Godfrey's car, but he can't then find a way by. Steve Hill down towards turn seven. He's going to have to joker soon. Godfrey and Tohill are second and third, and Derek Tohill is running out of laps. Four laps for the heat, six for the semi-finals and finals. There is Steve Hill going for the joker. He does exactly the same thing. Loses traction, slides off the road. Julian Godfrey goes through, back into the race lead. Derek Tohill behind him. And at the checkered flag, it's three from three for Julian Godfrey. Derek Tohill takes second. Pat Durham third ahead of Steve Hill in fourth place. At the end of Q3, Julian Godfrey then it is that takes yet another fastest time ahead of Derek Tohill. Pat Durham is third quickest from Steve Hill. Mike Manning ahead of Liam Manning and then Steve Mundy.
Mike Manning, I think it's fair to say you had quite a difficult first few events for the Fiesta last year, but you came out of the blocks fighting this morning really quick and then a couple of problems.
Yeah, no, this morning we had a little problem with a gear cut on it, but we sorted that out and it was really good gear changes and best it's ever gone.
Competing with Liam again, how's that rivalry going?
Yeah, it's all good. I love watching him in it anyway, so it's all good fun.
And the other British rounds you mentioned, where do you expect to do those? Obviously, Pembrey's your home track. Does it depend where the car is when you're doing the European rounds?
Yeah, well, obviously we do Lydon shortly, and then Pembrey, and then I'm not too sure then because we're going to June and July, and so we've got to see where we are in Europe, etc.
Derek, you and Julian Godfrey have a long history in rallycross, don't you? Right back to racing standard cars in the stock hatch category, and you're still at it today.
Absolutely, there was nothing in it back then, and there's very little in it today. Yeah, we'll keep the pressure on them in the final and see what happens. But there for the taking, there's nothing in it between us, so game on.
Steve Hill, a solid day for you here at Silverstone. I think first round of the British Rallycross Championship, but you're on the outside of the grid for the final, and although you're third overall, that's maybe not the perfect place to be.
Not the perfect place, but you never know. I haven't made a start yet today, so because in so much wheel spin off the start, I'm just trying to temper that back. The flat shift doesn't work, so if I can either clutch it or get a bit less wheel spin, hopefully I'll make a start.
Super National is always a competitive category. The Super 1600s mixed in with them once again. We're set for more action. It was Jack Thorne's Super 1600 Renault Twingo that was quickest in Q1 ahead of Paige Bellaby and Craig Lomax, with the reigning Super National champion Tristan Ovenden only fourth. He topped the times in Q2 though, ahead of Bellaby and Thorne, with Irishman Peter McGarry fourth as we get set for Q3. Q3 for Super National set to blast away. Now, Tristan Ovenden's omnipotent Clio V6 thunders away from pole position, and a great start there is made by Peter McGarry from the second row. He's Derek Tohill's spotter, he's in a Derek Tohill car, and he's up into second place with Jack Thorne alongside him in the little Twingo. The reigning Super 1600 champion looking for a European season this year gets attacked from Paige Bellaby's Lotus as Craig Lomax here in the Citroën heads for the loose. They work their way over the jump for the first time, but it's Ovenden ahead of McGarry with Jack Thorne's stubby little Twingo looking for a way by. There, the BMW 273, that's Paul Johnson, a welcome newcomer to the British Rallycross Championship. Paige Bellamy, who has always gone well in this Lotus, bounced back at the end of last season, then had to miss the last round, and Dad Dave won here at Silverstone. What can she do here? Craig Lomax hard at work as he comes over the line, but Tristan Upenden is just ahead of Peter McGarry. Look as they turn their way now out of turn one with Jack Thorne trying to stay with them. Peter McGarry doing a very good job indeed. Now what, if anything, can he do about that very powerful Renault ahead? Peter in the Fiesta, a regular in the Irish Championship, but he's going after the reigning Super National Champion, Tristan Upenden here. The double champion, both last year and 2017, has the advantage. Fourth is Bellamy. They can see Paul Johnson going through in fifth place up from the last row of the BMW, and Jack Thorne gets into the back of McGarry, who's almost come to a dead stop down at turn seven. They all concertina as they head through that tight right-hander. Craig Lomax then back on the power, and he's heading for the Joker. It's the longer, slower, tighter line round the outside. Tristan Upenden in the meanwhile is getting away. Second still, Peter McGarry. Third is Jack Thorne, and fourth there is the Lotus, and that's McGarry in the background, having got it all wrong. The Fiesta spins away from second, so he drops not to third, but to fourth place now. Peter McGarry will be seething about that. He's made a mistake, having shown good pace. And look now at Tristan Upenden's advantage. It's a monster. Jack Thorne runs second, third is Paige Bellamy, and there, coming into land, Peter McGarry. So the Irish driver, and it'd be great to see him do a full season, has got work to do now, trying to close onto the back of the Lotus Exige, and McGarry comes to a halt at turn seven, finds a gear, accelerates away, but that's even more time lost. Leader onto the last lap, Paige Bellamy with the water pouring onto the screen. Visibility becoming more of an issue. Now the track has been watered, but Paige Bellamy in the lightweight Lotus dances back onto the tarmac. There is McGarry behind, and Craig Lomax coming into the mix as well, having jokered a couple of laps back. Lomax, who's another Super 1600 competitor, heading then up now towards the right and the left. They're all mixed in, of course, again together this season, but you have got Super 1600 spec cars against the more powerful, larger engine Super Nationals, but a well-driven Super 1600 is competitive, evinced by Jack Thorne's efforts here. He always goes well around Silverstone. It's a tight, twisty circuit, and Jack Thorne, winner here last year, is closing on Upenden as they go for the Joker now. Clio V6 versus Super 1600 Twingo. Upenden has got the power down. He's going to sprint his way now back towards the tarmac ahead, but Jack Thorne is right there behind him. Can he have a go? To the chequered flag, Tristan Upenden it is then who wins. Jack Thorne takes second, and third goes the way of Paige Bellamy. For fourth, it's just Peter McGarry. At the end of Q3, Tristan Upenden is the fastest. Jack Thorne second from Paige Bellamy and Peter McGarry. Craig Lomax fifth, ahead of Paul Johnson, in sixth in the BMW. And that means that Upenden it is that tops qualifying jointly with Jack Thorne. Paige Bellamy comes next, ahead of Peter McGarry, and then Craig Lomax in fifth. Junior Rallycross is another hugely competitive category. And here at Silverstone for the opening round, we're getting ready for the final. Within the Motorsport UK Junior Rallycross Championship, Luke Constantine tops qualifying for Robert Vittoles and Patrick O'Donovan. Luke Constantine then on pole position for this six-lap final. With him at the front of the grid, Robert Vittoles, and then it is Patrick O'Donovan lining up alongside the Latvian in the middle of the front row. James Constantine, Luke's cousin, is on row two with Alfie Porter. Then it's Ben Sayer, Archie Thomas and Tom Upenden at the back of the grid as we go racing. The Suzuki Swift blast away. The red car of Robert Vittoles makes the best start then on the run down towards turn one. 1300cc cars for everybody, relatively underpowered, but it's a great training ground for the young drivers. And it's the 16-year-old Latvian, Robert Vittoles, then who leads the way with Patrick O'Donovan up into second place. O'Donovan almost into the back of Vittoles there as they come across the loose for the first time. O'Donovan it is that runs second. And then Luke Constantine, the man that started on pole position, has dropped back into third place. He's got some work to do. And Ben Sayer on the outside there, fifth, trying to work his way out from the back row of the grid and going nicely in his second season in the championship. O'Donovan there in the yellow car, joined in halfway through last season. Ollie O'Donovan's son. and he's learnt well. He's raced here before, of course, at the back end of last season, and he's going strongly now. Others go for the Joker lap, so O'Donovan tries to pick up a place, and the Joker is served by Luke Constantine early on. Ben Sayer still on the attack, James Constantine fending him off. But now Robert Vitholz then leads the way. Can he break away and preserve the advantage on the Joker lap? Let's see. Ben Sayer still hard at work. And then you've also got in 2.62 Alfie Porter in the car that Tom Constantine took to win the championship last year. Ben Sayer up on the outside line there, turning down towards turn five, but he still can't find a way by. On board with Patrick O'Donovan then now as he's back onto the power. So Vitholz it is up front as he comes then across the loose, back towards tarmac. The gap between the top two, nothing at all. Tyres squeal as they round turn one, and O'Donovan then crawling all over the back of the race leader here. Vitholz it is, just having the advantage at the moment. But while they're squabbling, they're holding each other up, and that means that Luke Constantine, who jokered early, in real terms, is catching back up to them here. Turning their way out of turn five now, back onto the power, but O'Donovan looks for a way by as they head across the loose, hard on the brakes into this tight right at turn seven. O'Donovan, who debuted last year, goes for the inside line, elbows out, but he's going to go through and take the race lead away from Roberts Vitholz. Through he goes. Vitholz now goes for the Joker lap, having debuted in the Junior Rallycross UK scene in a BTRDA Clubman's round last year. Vitholz now in for the full main British Rallycross Championship season. He's going to lose second as well. Look, Luke Constantine, having jokered early on, goes past him. And so Roberts Vitholz now loses first and second places. It's all unravelling for him. Having led for so long, now he's really on the back foot. Tom Ovenden is hard at play there, looking to get past and succeeding in getting through on Alfie Porter. James Constantine over the jump, and Luke Constantine could be on here for a race win, because if the Joker stagger works in his favour when this man, Patrick O'Donovan, serves it, then Constantine could be in the box seat. James Constantine in second place at the moment has also yet to Joker. And there is Vitholz, so he's in fourth on the road. He is right on the tail of Constantine, but can he find a way back past him? Luke Constantine then goes through ahead of cousin James, who has just jokered. That's another place gained. Roberts Vitholz looks to the inside line, starting the last lap now. So that's Patrick O'Donovan, but has he done enough to maintain the advantage over this man, Luke Constantine, the man that started on pole position? We won't know until we get to the stagger. O'Donovan heads over the jump. He's got to push here. Roberts Vitholz, in the meantime, is crawling all over the back and perhaps therefore just delaying Luke Constantine a fraction. Vitholz has a look to the inside at turn five. Can he get up alongside? He tries. They lean on each other. O'Donovan is down at turn seven. Out of turn six, Kink comes second and third, nose to tail. Ben Sayer, as he has done for much of the race, is crawling all over the back of James Constantine. Here is O'Donovan. He's off the road on the Joker. That's going to cost him time. Now, where is Luke Constantine? There he is. He's got the momentum. O'Donovan sorts out his slide. Up towards the timing line they come. It's going to be a virtual dead heat, and it's Constantine on the line. Luke Constantine it is, who just gets his nose in front to win the Motorsport UK Junior Rallycross Championship Final. Second, it is Patrick O'Donovan. And third goes to early leader Roberts Vitholz. Great action as ever from the juniors here at Silverstone. Confirmation of those results. Luke Constantine it is who wins by 38 thousandths of a second. Patrick O'Donovan the runner-up, Roberts Vitholz third, ahead of James Constantine, Ben Sayer and Archie Thomas in sixth. And you take that top six, and that's your championship order after one round. Luke Constantine with a 3-point cushion over Patrick O'Donovan and then Roberts Vitholz.
Luke, pole position for the final, a really hard day for you, close racing all day long, and you only just nicked victory right at the line.
Yeah, it was really close. I took the Joker really early because I thought I could try and get some clean air. Once I got my head down, I felt like I was going well, and I only just got it at the end, so yeah, really good.
It was unlucky to lose out just by under a second. It was 0.038, so it was really unlucky, but I feel as if I've come on a lot, and that I've really improved as a driver, and the car feels stronger this year. It's definitely a confidence boost knowing that I know the circuits this time and I know my way around. I'm not learning it. So I'm really looking forward to Lydon, one of my favourite on the calendar, so really looking forward to it, yeah.
After struggling a little bit in the first two, three heats, a little bit adapting with the car and with the track, it was a great school and great learning today, and we grab really, really important championship points, so looking forward to Lydon Hill.
The Motorsport UK Super National Rallycross Championship final is good to go, with Tristan Ovenden on pole from Jack Thorne and Paige Bellamy with him on row one. Then Irishman Peter McGarry shares row two with Craig Lomax. And the third row is Jarek Sukowicki, Adam Mills and Paul Johnson's BMW. Six laps of action is underway. Bad start by Craig Lomax, bad start by Jack Thorne. The Twingo staggers away from the line, and so Tristan Ovenden leads into turn one, being chased by Peter McGarry. Paige Bellamy goes third then as the cars accelerate now up towards turns two and three into the chicane. Across the loose they dance. This is Paige Bellamy hard at work up towards the jump. The lightweight Lotus, always a quick car, lands really nose heavy. Hopefully that won't have done any damage. And Jack Thorne, after that ghastly start, coming back into the mix now. The reigning Super 1600 champion, who's got a European Championship assault as his main agenda this year. The leader is getting away, Tristan Ovenden, but Peter McGarry in second place has got them all stacked up behind him now as Bellamy goes sideways. This is her view. Grabs a gear from loose to tarmac, speed building, then down through the gears, stand on the brakes and turn sharp right. The Lotus gets all sideways, so that means Paige Bellamy is under attack now from Jack Thorne. Jack, briefly a supercar racer the year that Dan Rook was British champion, ran out of budget, has come back, regrouped and goes really well in these machines. And look at that, dives up the inside. Got a lot of air, landed late, had all the momentum, cannons up the inside and goes ahead of Paige Bellamy. Wow! Air traffic control just about gave clearance for Jack Thorne to come into land at the right moment. Through he has gone into third place. Craig Lomax sees Paige Bellamy go for the Joker. He now sets off in pursuit of the other Super 1600 car. Tristan Ovenden then has a happy advantage at the moment. Peter McGarry is second, but Jack Thorne is reeling him in. Makes you wonder what he could have done back for that pop start. McGarry getting crossed up out of turn one. They're on the loose, they're out of turn three, heading up towards the jump, over which there Tristan Ovenden has just come. There is Adam Mills in the Mazda RX-8. It's an unusual rallycross car, but it goes nicely. Ovenden down towards turn seven. This is the fight for second place. Peter McGarry just ahead of Jack Thorne. They break, they turn through that tight right, Lomax, then Bellamy, and then the Mazda RX-8 behind. Blue on one side, orange on the other. Paige Bellamy in the Lotus accelerates through. She's already jokered. Craig Lomax here is jokering, and he's all arms and elbows looking for traction. Bellamy goes back ahead. So Paige Bellamy retakes the place on the Joker. Six lap race, and Tristan Ovenden on a dry road is looking unstoppable up front. Last year, bad weather really affected the Clio a bit round here, but on a day like today, he's able to put all of that power down and he's pulling well clear. As here, Bellamy is right onto the tail of Peter McGarry now. This is for third place as they come over the jump. Again, the Lotus so light, lands nose heavy, dwarfed by the Fiesta ahead. To the loose once more, Bellamy hunting down the Fiesta of Peter McGarry, and Craig Lomax is closing in behind them. There is the orange Mazda of Adam Mills, accelerating his way out of turn five, down towards us. He's got Paul Johnson's BMW as his next target as he comes now into the right at turn seven. Blue on one side, as I said, orange on the other. Now for the race lead, Tristan Ovenden is away and gone. He's got 9.5 seconds, give or take, in hand over Jack Thorne, but third place is up for grabs. There's the race leader, and Tristan Ovenden sets up the ex-Jamie Bird Clio for turn seven as Bellamy clatters back onto the ground. She's on the tail of McGarry, but can't find a way past him. Tristan Ovenden this time will have to go for the Joker. He's got to be oh so careful. had people jokering and slithering off the road, but no dramas for Tristan Lovenden, who is going to win round one of the Motorsport UK Super National Rallycross Championship from Jack Thorne in second place, and Irish visitor Peter McGarry hangs on for third as he comes across the line. Paige Bellaby will be fourth, Craig Lomax for fifth, and sixth newcomer Paul Johnson. A great start to the season for Tristan Lovenden. So Tristan Lovenden it is who wins round one from Jack Thorne and Peter McGarry. Paige Bellaby fourth from Craig Lomax, Paul Johnson and Jarek Sukowiecki, with Adam Mills spinning at the end.
Tristan, you didn't go as well as you do on other circuits at this venue last year, but today you've absolutely smashed it and won yet again.
Yeah, I'm so pleased. No, we haven't. The best I've had here is third in the last 2 years. That's the best we've managed. So it's one I've really, really wanted to do well at. And the weather's been great, which I think probably has helped us a little bit. But yeah, it's worked out and I'm so pleased here.
It's hard work against these rear-wheel drive cars, isn't it? They beat you off the line and you've got to do a lot during the race to catch them up. Another solid drive, you must be happy with that.
Yeah, we're over the moon result. With this weather and the conditions, power comes into play. It's very hard to get the Joker right, to come out in clean air, to be able to chase down and run out of laps, unfortunately, but I think we set the fastest lap at Super National as well, so still very, very pleased with the result.
Peter, your first appearance in the British Championship for quite some time in a totally different car, and you've gone pretty well.
Thrown in the deep end, I think, a bit hard, yeah. But, slight bit of a late decision to take Saul over Derek's double European winning touring car. So, yeah, it was a great opportunity. Took up with both hands. Got a bit greasy this morning. We had a few issues with various small little bits and pieces. But, yeah, settled in a little bit now for the final and felt a lot more comfortable and would have enjoyed another couple of laps now, I have to say. So, yeah. Watch this space maybe for later on the season.
So one round into the Motorsport UK Super National Rallycross Championship and Tristan Lovenden leads the title race. 3 points ahead of Jack Thorne with Peter McGarry third and Paige Bellaby fourth. It's been a day of drama for the supercars. Two groups for Q1. Derek Toehill racing at Silverstone for the first time won the first race of the supercar season, being chased by Steve Hill. But the time wasn't quite quick enough to fend off Julian Godfrey out of the second race. He had to try to beat Pat Doran, Mike Manning and Steve Mundy. He did that and he also set the fastest time in Q1. In Q2, Godfrey took on Toehill. They were side by side down towards the first corner, but it was Godfrey that made the better line through the right-hander and then tried to build the advantage over the chasing Irishman. Toehill threw everything at it, but there was just no stopping Godfrey. What about Q3? Same story, Godfrey versus Toehill, and it was Godfrey that was at turn one ahead, and there he stayed. They both slivered off the road together on the Joker lap though, but even so, Godfrey was able to keep Toehill at bay. Steve Hill also sliding wide late race. It means that after the three qualifying runs, Julian Godfrey tops qualifying from Derek Toehill and then Steve Hill. Pat Doran fourth, Steve Mundy fifth, and then it's Liam Manning. We're getting ready for the final here at Silverstone, and there are more supercar drivers set to join the British Rallycross Championship later in the year. Let's hear from some of them now.
Roger Thomas, you've got an M Sport built Ford Fiesta for later in the year. When can we expect to see it out?
Hopefully. I've been promised by M Sport that it'll be ready for Lydon, so all fingers crossed for Lydon.
And bringing a car like that over from America, it's a proper car, it's competed at World Championship level, so you must be excited to get involved in that sort of thing.
Very excited, yes. It did the American Rallycross for two or three seasons, I believe, and it's been rebuilt completely from the floor up by Tony Bardi. And M Sport doing the engine, so yeah, very, very excited, can't wait.
And there are drop rounds in the British Championship, so you're not at a total loss from missing the round one?
Thankfully, yes. But I think I've played me drop now, so yeah, we'll do our best and go as hard as we can for the remaining rounds.
Simon Horton, we haven't seen you for a while in the British Rallycross Championship, but I know you've been working hard over the winter on your Subaru Impreza, and you tried to be here, but you can be out for the rest of the rounds this year?
Yeah, absolutely. Unfortunately, we were about 1 week away from being here. It was so close. Unfortunately, due to work commitments, we just couldn't quite make the deadline. But yeah, we'll be at Lydon and also the rest of the championship. We've committed to the full British. A few upgrades on the car for this year. A couple of people won't have seen it for a little while, but hoping it should be very competitive anyway. That's what we're saying.
The final of round one of the Motorsport UK British Rallycross Championship is set to blast into life. Julian Godfrey is on pole position, Derek Tohill alongside him, and Steve Hill completes row one. It's Pat Doran and Steve Mundy on row two. It is Liam and Mike Manning on row three. The Toyo Tyres Motorsport UK British Rallycross Championship final is go. Can Derek Tohill get ahead of Julian Godfrey? The answer is no. Godfrey on the inside line just gets his nose in front. Tohill breaks as late as he dares, locks up, scrabbles through the corner, looks for the undercut, can't do it. Godfrey is ahead as they head up towards turn two. Is that game over? Can Derek Tohill do anything now to unsettle Julian Godfrey and find a way past him? It is not going to be easy. Over the jump they come. The Mitsubishi it is that has the advantage, but Derek Tohill will be oh so determined to make the trip from Southern Ireland a worthwhile one and go away with maximum points if he can. But right now, Julian Godfrey, the five times British champion, has got the answer to him. Pat Doran versus Steve Hill for the last podium place here. They are together as they work their way now through the normal lap. For the Joker goes Steve Mundy. There are the leaders. Godfrey, it is just ahead at the moment. Super national champion, five times a British champion from the supercar class. And he's got Derek Tohill, another very accomplished driver, chasing after him. They both started off in Stock Hatch, where they raced against one another. They're carrying on the rivalry into supercars. There is Julian Godfrey coming over the jump down towards turn five. Steve Hill just dropping off the back a little bit of Pat Doran. Julian Godfrey here in the Mitsubishi Mirage down towards the right-hander at turn seven. Despite that amazing accident at Croft last year, he was still in contention to win the championship last season. Didn't quite happen for him, but Julian Godfrey certainly came on strong in the second half of last year, and he's looking very strong indeed to kick off 2019. There is Derek Tohill out of turn one. This is his view. Grabs a gear, stand on the brakes through the right and left sequence that takes you onto the loose and then up towards the jump. Too much air here, you land late, you run out of time to get the car slowed down and then turn in. But Derek Tohill, even though he's giving away track knowledge to Godfrey, is acquitting himself very well indeed. The car's turning their way from turn seven, and there Pat Doran is coming under renewed attack from Steve Hill. Reliability used to be the drama for the Mitsubishi. That seems to have been ironed out, and year after year Steve Hill gets more and more competitive in that car. Certainly overdue a win. He's very well deserving of a win, but it ain't going to be today because Godfrey and Tohill are up front, and it looks as though the gap is widening between them as Steve Hill challenges for third place there. Sideways out of turn three, up through the gears, heading towards the jump now. That's Pat Doran with the Citroën C4, the car that Nathan Heathcote took to the title. It's a very well used car, but it's competitive still. And it's reliable, and it is doing Pat Doran very proud indeed, because he's still there in third place and looking as though that last podium spot will be his. Steve Hill goes for the Joker. That gets him out of the traffic. So can he therefore get ahead of Doran when the multiple British champion Joker's late race? The dust is kicked up by the sideways Mitsubishi as back to tarmac comes Steve Hill. There is Pat Doran turning his way right through turn two, but Julian Godfrey is getting away from Derek Tohill. The gap is building between them. Derek not being able to stay with him. Now there is Mike Manning. He had mechanical dramas early on in the day, but all is good now. Mike will do some British rounds, but it's the European Championship that he's got his eye on. The European Championship comes to Silverstone alongside the world in late May. Godfrey goes for the Joker. Derek Tohill does not. That therefore should give him the lead on the track. Yes, it does. So now Derek Tohill has got to push like crazy to try to build the lead. He will Joker at the end of the last lap. There is Mike Manning. Son Liam in the Subaru, Mike in the Fiesta. Race leader Derek Tohill, but he's ahead for the moment because of the Joker lap, and Julian Godfrey slides a little bit deep out of turn two. Will that compromise him? Let's see. Doran versus Hill still for third place. They come through across the loose, and there is Derek Tohill sawing away at the wheel. The Irishman with the Irish tricolour proudly displayed on the front of the car comes out of turn seven. He's ahead of Julian Godfrey, but I don't think he's ahead by enough. Derek Toehill goes for the Joker. This is the fight for third place. Durand versus Hill. Pat Durand goes defensive, and Julian Godfrey takes back the race lead and wins round one of the Toyo Tyres Motorsport UK British Rallycross Championship from Derek Toehill in second place. And third will go the way of Pat Durand. He fends off Steve Hill on the run up towards the chequered flag. Great battle between the two of them. And it is Durand just from Hill, with fifth going the way of Mike Manning. So Julian Godfrey by 2.5 seconds wins round one from Derek Toehill. And Pat Durand, the third driver on the podium.
Familiar position for you to be in, but a fantastic win for the first round of the British Rallycross Championship.
Yeah, it's been a good event this weekend. Won all the qualifying heats and the final. No, got again a really good start in the final. No, it all went perfect, no mistakes. And the track was nice to drive today. Very happy with it.
Derek, I know before the final you were hoping to score a victory here round one of the British Rallycross Championship, but you pushed Julian hard all day and you must be pretty pleased with second position.
Yeah, look, Julian drove very well. He had us off the line all day and gave it everything I had. Tried to keep him honest, hoped he'd maybe make a mistake, but Julian, I think, is 5 times British champion, so he tends not to make too many mistakes. But, well, we were there, ready to pounce if he did. And enjoyed our first run around the track, so hats off to Julian, drove great all day. And, we'll try and reverse it next time out.
Pat, you turned up for the final round of the British Rallycross Championship here at Silverstone last year and finished on the podium. You've come for the first round this time out and done the same thing.
Done it again. What a superstar I am. No, it's worked out for me. A lot of people pulled out and I've taken a few places and really enjoyed it.
Quite a hard battle with Steve in the final.
Yeah, I think half the race was defending more than trying to race because the radio was going mad with my spotter screaming at me, keep it tight, keep it tight. And so I wasn't really on the line for the last couple of laps. But yeah, the old car's got it and really happy.
Julian Godfrey leaves Silverstone as the championship leader, just like last year. Derek Toehill is the nearest opposition with Pat Durand third, Steve Hill fourth ahead of Mike Manning, and then Steve Mundy. The next stop is going to be Lyddon Hill on Easter Monday.